Hello, I'd like to welcome back to Doom, or specifically, I haven't said this in a while, specifically the Cacowards of Doom. What was I going to say? The 2009 Cacowards, we are entry number 4, which is called Mapgame. I haven't said that in a while, but just in case you forgot about it and you're watching this in one big flow, don't forget that part, it's really important. But besides that, this is probably going to be the last video for Mapgame, because Mapgame is a single episode replacement, which means that it's kind of limited to content. It's like 9 levels or something, usually. Last time we did some levels, and we also looked at a bunch of schematics, some information stuff. I don't really know what I'm doing in this level, but... How do you interact with that? God damn it, I hurt myself. There were two there? Oh, fuck. Ah, Apfelstrudel. My ear itches. Ah. I hate it when my lobes itch. But yeah, considering that it's a... Oh, there we go. Now it will break open. Considering that we're playing an episode. Fuck, what is he even saying? Why am I so confused about this? I didn't even know what I was gonna say. Something about an episode. Considering playing episode 1, there's like 9 levels, and we've already been through most of them by now, so... Oh, I sees ya. God damn it, I hate rockets. Mostly because I still don't fully, mostly understand and appreciate their nuances. So that's a secret, huh? A couple of armor bonuses and a big fat... I guess a supercharge is really nice. That's not a bad secret. Especially considering that it seems to be going all over the place. Just go down. Thank you, sir. Wham bam, thank you. Okay, so this is where the ordinary door is at. So we've done everything normally. Okay. Tap, tap, tap. Okay. Oh, let's see. I can see the hall. That's really nice. Should be careful. The barrels seem a little bit different. Usual. They just feel a little different. I don't know why. So now we have the yellow key. We can go back and do the yellow key thing. Oh! The revolving chair for some reason. Oh, wait, I can't access that. Huh. Okay. I guess that's a mystery to figure out then, huh? Oh, I've been through this area completely. There's a couple of places I missed. This place allows you that. Well, thank you, sir. I really do very much appreciate your assistance in the matter. Wow, a rocket launcher box? That's cool. Been a bit since I've had some good rocket launchers in my pocket. That's a cute little fan, though. There, clean up. Wait. But if they broke it apart, then... Then who the fuck did it? Because there's no one left. Must have been you. Oh, this mysterious, handsome fellow. There's something going on out back there, it seems. Oh, that's so cool. That is so cool. Like, I'll give it that much. That's pretty fucking clever. I also love how that works. Although the texture really doesn't gel well. It looks pretty cool. Have we been here? Maybe something. Nope. It's a good place to hide like a baby lover. Okay, now we're outside. But what we want to do is we want to get access to the... There we go. Yeah! In the original Doom, this particular level, if I remember if I recall the level that I'm thinking of correctly, I always got a bit befuddled by the bridge because I don't think I ever figured out which switch activated in the first place. So, there's a little trivia fact for you that nobody cares about. Tough this one out, huh? Yeah! What you guys gonna do, huh? Gonna sit there, eat it like good boys. Ugh. Really, that's not a shooty switch? There's an ancient Chinese secret. Yeah, so that lever's already pressed. Huh. Well, I don't usually like that, but whatever. I guess I'll go for some invisibility. Actually, that's pretty good against hitscan enemies, since it gives you a raw... gives you a raw it gives enemies raw mischance, so it's actually pretty good against just hit scan enemies since you can't regularly dodge projectiles. And that, I guess. The problem is if you're used to dodging projectiles, the missing might be a bit of a concern. Oh! Those are, I like those kinds of secrets, which makes me sad that I didn't find them myself. Wasn't also what I expected to find. Oh, look, we got 4 out of 6 secrets! Although I got 3 out of 6 if you want to count me being an idiot and an asshole. Kind of curious what the others might be. Yeah, that's the exit. It really doesn't mess around with the exit door, does it? It's just like, once you get an exit, you get your exits. Oh, that's cool, put a little platform for the... Oh, he's doing this one. They all do this one at some point. Well, 10 minutes in. Bunch of ammo. Anything at the starting blocks? Nope. Didn't see anything either, so. Yeah. Like, if there's ever an instance to use the fucking rocket launcher in a regular goon, it would be that one. I guess I could use some green armor at some point in the future. I do love just how easy these secrets are. I'm not the best kind of looker. Mostly because I don't like doom secrets too much. As I've explained, they sometimes just get really ridiculous, but here, I'm really enjoying them. I mean, there's a couple of ones that are really clever, and there's a couple of ones which are just kind of like, you know... For if you really just... If you want to pay attention, if you really need supplies, and you really want to put forth a little extra effort to look for something... Oh my god. Oh my god, that's such a fucking Doom 2 thing to do. Now, yep. Where am I? Yeah, I'm just gonna clean you guys up in advance. That's pretty... This is so awesome! Already found 2 out of 3 secrets! I feel so smart! Oh, I can feel the smarts flowing through my brain space. Soon I will become the smartest man. And then I'll show all of you. Go up there. And deal with a jerk. Or go over here. And punch a jerk. I think I don't need to punch any jerks, because they're all just infighting now. They really sound like they're having a wonderful time. I still wish that someone would just make the shotgun into a non-shotgun weapon. You know, make him give him a straight aim, all that stuff. That'd be cool. I'm gonna need the big boy gun for this one. I have another one, but I guess I might as well. I just want to know. Just need one more secret. Oh, I got both the items already. So whatever's in the secret is not a counting item. Which means it's not going to be something big. That's where it came from. IIRC. Shotgun's not a terrible idea. Anything around here I need to know of? I just want to know where the last one's at. What was that? Those are really loud. Oh, I get it. I get it. I know exactly what just happened. That's not what I expected, but pretty close. As in, not too far off, I guess. What could that last secret be, then? Might be back there, actually. Ah, let's just focus on the mission at hand. It's just an area. Really? There's gotta be something down there, right? No! Really? Huh. Is that the lever was pulled, I guess. That lever did something. But what did it do? Is always the real question. It might have opened that thing over there, I guess. But yeah, the reason I usually don't do Doom Secrets is people tend to be very mean with them. Like, they make it a one-time shot, or they just make it very annoying, or you have to somehow figure out what buttons do. I prefer my secrets a little bit more open than that. A little bit more polite about the matter. This turret all the way over there. You're dealing with a highly suboptimal situation. Well, I say suboptimal, but I really meant this situation I just conquered. Expected to be there. I'm impressed a shotgun can do that kind of work at all. So, nothing here, huh? Where's the fucking secret at? Oh, there's a little pipe that doesn't do anything. That's cute. I have way too many shotgun rounds, mostly because I don't have the double barrel all the time. Weighing and measuring my attack more. I guess by taking away the minigun and replacing it with the flare gun, it does kind of limit how much long-distance accuracy you have. Nothing? None. Except maybe this thing. Yeah. So that's the last secret, huh? That's not a bad one. It's obvious enough on the way back. Okay. This guy's not used teleporters. Did those exist in this version, even? I don't even know. I think not. I guess not. Like, if it existed, it would have been used by now. You know what I also kind of like is bonus secrets. Like, they're secrets, but they're not mentioned at the counter. So you can find little extra collectibles and feel really smart. These are really tiny hitboxes. Oh, this is something so satisfying about scoring a double kill on those fuckers. With the regular shotgun, at least. Happens a lot more with the double barrel. Fuck. How much health do imps have? Interesting factoids! They have 60 health, double amount of the shotgunner man. Shotgunner man is 30 compared to 20 of the zombie man, which are the guys with the guns. Heavy attacker, the heavy machine gun guys are 70, which is really interesting. It's really fun to just read up on some Doom statistics sometimes. Their claw does the same amount of damage as their shooty thing, so standing up close or taking it from afar is really no major difference. Where are the rest of these fucking... Oh, there they are. Oh, there... Oh, he does use teleporters, huh? Caco demons! Wow! It's a little late to start introducing some enemy variety, but sure. I have not fought Cacko Demons with a fucking shotgun in a long-ass time. So, one question. It's clearly possible to edit things into episode 1. Would that stop anyone from retrofitting an entire Doom episode into old versions? Oh, I missed an enemy. Must have been one that didn't get out of the teleporter. So how big is this level? That's a little bigger, but it seems to be mostly decoration. There's only one ancient Chinese cigarette for us to uncover. Which is, as I expected, this. I'm gonna pick that up last. It's not a well-hidden secret, considering it's on the fucking map like that, but sure, whatever. So considering that this thing does 30 minimal... Fuck, this is really bad. Shit, die. Yeah, we're in a bad spot. This is really bad. Didn't it give you invulnerability or something in the original? Or maybe give you a soul supercharge? Oh, that's what happens. They teleport out of that place. That's what happens. Okay. I thought they were externals. No, they were perfectly internal enemies. Being replaced. What really sucks is walking diagonally into an attack like that. An attack has already passed you and just walk into it like an idiot. Cause I'm breaking your ring. Oh, there's a cap demon up there, huh? That's gonna be a little bit more of a stiff resistance. Shouldn't have picked up that supercharge. That supercharge was a waste. As is my very restrained strategy. Anyone left to call the Tahita Fajita Club? I thought so. This is a pretty good last level. It's got a lot of punch, a lot of bite. But it's restrained in an elegant fashion. Rare to see a final level like that. So very delicately. King Hell! Things just got bad! Oh, from up there. Okay. Yeah, there are really no good weapons to fight these dudes with except rockets. Of which I do not have many. With a shotgun, not exactly fun business. This is a really good one, though. Frick. Like, it sure caught me off guard and cost me a lot of supplies to deal with the situation. That's so cool. Oh, that's so cool. That's awesome. That's a good job. Good thing I saved that armor. Nice use of the bridge. And a good, nice, consistent theme of the palette. It's a really good job. That's really cool. Let me guess. Thank you. Just a portal, huh? Odd. Ooh, that's a hell portal if I ever did see one. And as expected, we get one of these. That was amazing. My God. Mapgame. That was great. Nice classic feel. Good strong bite. Very solid use of a limited weapon selection. Perfect custom enemy. Lovely replacement for the minigun. I gotta say this much, Ravage. That is a grade A map pack. That is a WAD that once you find it, you're like, wow, what a WAD. And you don't walk away disappointed. Let's go read some reviews. Bum 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 bum. Bum 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 bum. Boring. Aw, that's not true. I guess it is true. If you want variety, you're not gonna get many mix-ups. Enemy is very consistent. The turrets are really the biggest spice that's ever applied, but after the first couple levels, I disagree. The chain gun replacement is much better. I really love it. And the new shotgun sounds great. Absolute great levels. No need for gob. Yep, it's pretty fair. It's pretty fair. No working Z Doom. It does work in Z Doom. I played in Z Doom. Easy was map game 2. Oh, I hope there's a map game 2 coming up in the Cacowards. That could be great. I could look it up because I do think there's a wiki for people that make Doom mods. Excellent replacement for Doom E1. It's high quality, crisp. Yeah, it's so strong. That not really. Most switches were pretty obvious. Dura is not lame. Considering how Doom works, it's a really good enemy type, and he really used it in some really good situations. Some far away, some up close, some with some enemies in between, so that you can laugh as they get mowed down. And then you get too arrogant, and you get hit anyway because you stood there too long. Logan's an idiot. This is a great episode. Who the fuck is Logan, and why is he an idiot? Doesn't matter. Let's go read the actual Cacowards entry. At first glance, with 9 levels, it is very inspired. There's a couple of moments where you're like, is this really just supposed to be episode 1 or not? With a familiar ending at the final. Well, it's kind of a trope at this point. Everyone does it. Everyone does the die ending if they do episode 1. Yeah, Ravage really lived with some high quality work. Like, this is amazing. It's so good. The palette is really strong. Like, the selection and the placement's great. I guess that's true. I guess it is an easy one, huh? True. Without those two, I think that this would have been a much weaker WAD. If those weren't there, the sentry gun, then some encounters would be so bland. Next up is Legacy of Suffering. We all know that the Doom movie was terrible, so when I saw a mod was pissed, oh, we're gonna play the movie, huh? Wait. There's a quadruple barrel shotgun. Considering I love the double barrel, I think I'm going to have some fun. Oh, this is a mod, is it? I guess we'll see. I am looking forward to this. I think I'm going to give this one a quick play in a moment. Get a good feel for it. And maybe I'll play it completely and it won't be blind, but whatever. After that, we got Tribute, which looks... Ooh, Tribute looks like it's going to go a new fashion direction, because looking at that gun... Yeah, we're going to get some nice gameplay mods. After this one, which had a little bit, just enough to get interested... I'm looking forward to some more extreme overhauls with some more very distinct feels. Really good. Oh yeah, the onboard stuff. Build a tiny defense to kill thing, find a big computer, destroy some... I love this setup. It's like three imps, and then the escalation goes to Barons of Hell and some lost... Like, this is a really cool prompt because it's so odd. A good prompt is one that immediately piques the mind because it's so unique that you instantly have an idea, but it's nothing you've seen before. You're like, what level has three imps and a couple of Barons of Hell at the end? And a big computer you have to find. Nobody does that in Doom. Wait. And then you instantly have an image in your head, and you instantly know what you are going to make, what you think that idea should be. In a tiny, torn-apart, dark tech base, you can easily make sure that the imps are in the same computer room, and then the Barons are sort of scattered out, and you have to go back and forth. That's what I got in mind. Like, I instantly have an idea, and I rarely have ideas. Prompts are just miracle workers for me. Or you could have a room where the barons come out of the computer, and the imps are sort of just scattered on the way there. Or the imps are there at the beginning to give you this really high action-packed feel, but then there's nothing, and nothing, and nothing. You pick up more and more weapons, and you're like, when is it going to happen? And then you push your computer and you get this little cutscene, but during the cutscene, barons appear behind you. Ah, that'd be great. Deadline is January. I don't think these are ever published on the Cacowards. They exist, probably. They're somewhere, probably. But they're not in the Cacowards, to what I know of. I do need to remember to look through these. I'm not going to do these anymore because they're just not worth it. I'm also going to stop doing Worst Wad. Apparently, Worst Wad gets cut out later because there's no reason to give Worst... Yeah. I'm referring to the Dito... Oh, that's pretty cool! It's not about the Wad, but it's about the problem surrounding the Wad. Sweet detail guide. Continues to get... Oh, no! Ugly hyper detail. Oh, this is really cool. Mapping is an art, unless I just get to style, composition, texture. That's true. Like a big thing, I'm trying to learn to draw, and one of the big things I'm learning is actual anatomy is rarely as important for getting the feel of the image right. You know, like color composition and a sense of consistent style. You gotta pick something and stick to it. I mean, I draw shitty stuff that's really angular, but it looks really good because it's a single consistent style and it's true to itself. I'm gonna load up Sign. I'm gonna show you that one, because it's really cool. Sirisai, here we go. I'm talking specifically about this one. This is garbage. Like, in a raw sense, that's trash. But it's so consistently good that it works. And here, a single consistent style makes it look so much better. And here, I'm trying more washed out colors, and I'm trying consistent shading, and it gives a lot of texture and sense of depth to things. And that's so much more important than adding one more tiny vertex to make things look detailed. I'm going to look at this one because I'm curious to say what this means. Yeah, Thunder Peak was awesome. If Thunder Peak is the map I think it is, that map was awesome. But if you really have to know what you're doing, don't do something you don't understand because you will do it wrong. It's the same with satire. If you don't understand what you're satirizing, it's just going to be hot garbage and you're going to look like an idiot. Oh, man. Mapgame, you are awesome because you got me talking like this. Here, a round of applause for Mapgame. In my opinion, the best one of 2009, considering that kind of quality. But let's not say that that's the best for now, because we don't know. There are some upcoming, and after Mapgame, I'm really feeling it. So these two, they've got massive benefits. They got that second wind from coming off a great WAD. They got to prove themselves, but if they can, damn, I might just be unable to decide. And that's the best part, because these aren't organized in any particular order, so picking, who knows. Also, fun fact, Plutonia 2 is here, and it's on the Cacowards, which means that it's a long project, but it's also good, and that's awesome, because then it's either really good, or it's alright. I'm not going to read this until after I do Plutonia. The Killing Adventure. I think they got rid of Mockward 2. Yeah, but it's actually then why is it a Mockward? The Mockward is... named for mockery to mockery to the newbie's theme maps. Yeah. There's a reason they got rid of these. Goddamn. I am just full of energy. What a great way. It's not even 9:30, and I'm already just feeling it. Good job, Mapgame. Good job.